for this meeting.
Oh dear. Did it go to the Carmel address?
It probably did.
Oh shoot. I unfortunately, Sharon, I've been having trouble with my Carmel address.
Okay, let me look at the send. I was trying to do this very quickly.
Little last minute on my end. Sorry about that.
Now, Drew, it went to a Gmail account, and actually, no, Donna, let me see here.
Sharon, I think most of it went to their private emails when I'm kind of looking at the distribution list.
Oh, good. Thanks, Doctor. I'm looking, like Bill Cooler, it went to his personal. The others, and also Kelvin, it went to his personal. So I think you're right.
Maybe a mixed bag.
It could be. What I did was I grabbed an email that Jenny Stites had sent out to everybody and just pulled all of the names off of that.
I don't have it. I'm sorry.
Okay, let's see if I can.
Karen was kind enough to send me several emails.
Okay, let me, what email address, Donna, do you want me to use for you?
mamatut03@AOL.
AOL.com. Okay. I know sometimes the city email has problems with AOL, so let me...
Maybe that's it.
I'll shoot this to you really quick here, so hopefully you get it, okay?
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Hi.
Here we go.
Jen Bupp, are you on? I can't tell.
Yes. Can you hear me?
Okay.
Okay. We're going to call it to order. It's 5:02. And as we start, I wanted to give just a hearty thanks to Jill because she's going to take a run at the minutes for this meeting. Thank you, Jill.
You're welcome.
Beyond that, we will need to figure out how we handle it for the next couple of meetings until Jenny can come on and handle that for us starting in June. So we appreciate that. We do need approval of minutes, both for the January 19th meeting. There was some revision that needed to be made to those minutes, as well as the February 16th minutes. So if someone could offer a review and a motion to approve the January 19th minutes.
I'll offer a motion to approve the January 19th minutes.
Thank you.
I'll second.
Thank you, Drew, for that second. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed, same sign?
Aye.
I'm sorry, did someone say something? Okay. Anybody opposed to the minutes? All right, then the minutes are approved for the January 19th meeting, and thanks to Kelvin and to Jill for spending a little time to revise those to bring to final form. We next have the February 16th minutes to review and approve. Any questions, concern, discussion on those minutes before we take a motion? All right, can I get a motion to approve?
A motion to approve.
Thank you, Christina. Could I have a second, please?
I'll second.
Thank you very much, Drew. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Thank you so much. Opposed, same sign? All right, the minutes are approved. Thank you very much. Okay, the next item on the agenda is a monthly report from the city.
Julia, we don't have a report this particular month, okay?
Thank you. Yeah, I was informed that we didn't have a report, and I wasn't sure who would be attending. So, Sharon, it's good to see you. Thank you.
Good to see you, too.
For being here. Thank you. We are ready to move forward to update and review the completed intake form projects, and that would be specifically on a murals project. So I believe that Jen and John are going to walk us through. Sharon, anything to add to that, please do.
I do not. I'm ready to turn it over to them, and also, and Michael Klitzing, whatever you want to add in there as well.
Absolutely. I think probably best to have Jen and John Michael give the overview, because they've got all the important stuff. I'm just in a support role to help make it happen.
Okay, good.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for, again, this opportunity. We are so excited as we keep moving forward and how the pieces of the puzzle are starting to form. To just give you an update from our last meeting, we went back to the National Art Honor Society kids and we showed them the concepts, and we talked about the things that we had discussed in this meeting about what was important. And we all agreed on the one concept design that was more colorful. It had a little bit of a vibe of a cityscape and the musical instruments and the music notes. So what we did is we turned the kids loose and we said, okay, here are the major components that we're looking for. Now we're in the second draft revision stage. And this design, which was forwarded on to you all, was done by Caroline Hammonds, an incredible young lady, very motivated. We just thought she hit this out of the park. At our last meeting, you guys had requested some revised designs to choose from, but we really felt like this was just heads and shoulders above some of the other ideas. So at that point, I had the wonderful encounter with John Michael, and his background with mural design was exactly what we needed, because we, you know, are working with a curved tunnel surface, not a flat wall. So as you look at Caroline's design here, you have to envision this as a curved image. Her concept was light to dark, or day to night. And the ceiling portion would be the music kind of floating around through clouds. And we thought, what a beautiful representation of a tunnel. The idea of coming through this tunnel and experiencing a breeze of music. So we thought this design just really well suited the space. So John Michael came in and we were able to have some meetings and discussions of how do we translate this in a digital format, and how do we put this onto the tunnel surface itself. Our concern being obviously the kids' safety first and foremost with scaffolding. And so he shared his background and experience with tunnels and with design, digital design on murals. And he has some great suggestions to propose to the committee. So I'm going to go ahead and let him talk for a little bit about some ideas he had of how we could take this design. And we have the capability of making additions at this point. Anything the committee would like to see within the concept, we can still do that. And then also how we can apply it to the walls. So John Michael, you want to walk us through what you come up with?
Thanks, Jen. And thanks, everybody. Great opportunity. I don't know if you can share the screen with that slide deck. If so, I'll wait there. If not, perfect. Nice.
Are you seeing it now?
Yep. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. So yeah, after talking to Jen, she kind of laid it out well for me, and I work with a group of people. Many people doing different things. The focus that we took away was just the optimal application to get it done in a desired time frame. So by July-ish, Carmel Fest time frame. And so we know it has to be interactive, students being engaged. And so we thought of a giant coloring book. My background's also in insurance, so in the murals, you have to have insurance. And so we designed the process in a way that will keep everybody on the ground. So that'll be nice for the insurance piece. But a paint by number. And then the realistic aspect would be completing the ceiling in a wrap. And I'll get into that on the next slide. But the ceiling will be completed. And then as it comes down, it'll be the outline like a giant coloring book. And the numbers will be painted in the same color they'll be painted over with. And so we don't have to stamp it or anything like that. It'll be the same material. The way we get it digital is just a process called vectorizing. And we do that through Adobe Illustrator. So the design work, originally we thought we were going to have to do a lot of the design work, which is fine, and we're willing to do that. But Jen had a great idea of teaching the students how to do this process in a hands-on workshop. And so we're going to come in, teach the honor students, the arts honor students, how to do this and see where they might need help after that. So we'll assess and advise, perhaps the violin be isolated and get vectorized on its own and leave certain assets as individual assets for the board or the committee to say, we think that should be larger or smaller or tilted. It's still their artwork. Same with the cityscape and the sheets of music. We can arrange those in different ways. So once that's an image, it gets printed with a application called Aerotech, and we would go through EMI graphics there and install also with EMI's install team, trying to negotiate some sponsoring or donations with all that. All these products are through Sherwin-Williams too, and so everybody, Sherwin-Williams is used to offering free stuff to help out with these types of things. So then the mural painting, the strategy and the day of management, that's where the mural experience comes into play, and we can lay that out if you guys like where we're headed. The next slide is just kind of more details on the materials that we would use. And so the prep, the good thing is we walked through the tunnel and kind of got rough measurements, not precise yet. But the surface is in really good shape. So what this wrap, this Aerotech is basically paint, latex paint. So it stretches under different weather conditions and it has adhesive on the back. And so
Sheldon Okamoto
is now joining.
Oh, sorry. So we would also ask that the streets department or someone, there's a few areas that are kind of corroding or need prepped or skim coated over, but the big majority of the surface is ready to go and we'll be fine. So we would prep with like a Kills or a primer, then paint the caulking in between the sections. There's 11 sections on each side. So if you consider each section is like a rib, that's how the graphic will get installed. And so there will be 11 sections like that. The ceiling will be done and painted. And then the sides will come in like a coloring book for the paint by number. Then the in between those sections, there's a 2-inch gap of caulk. And we would just paint that black with a paint called A100, also by Sherwin-Williams. And also the utility boxes and there's circular cutouts that are filled in on the ceiling. So that would be maybe spray paint. We don't know yet, but something just black on those accent pieces. And then same material, latex 3000 ink resin. And then the thing with this is we got to pick a color palette and it can't be more than 7 colors for this application. And so Jen, or in conjunction with you all, need to select 7 colors in the palette you guys want. And then to finish it off, it's a shield concrete sealer, also through Sherwin-Williams, and it's a high gloss finish, and it'll probably require 2 coats, and it'll be really tough to do anything or do any damage or, you know, get this off of the tunnel and vandalize. It'll be easier to clean if that happens. And so here's just a few things, brushes and the sizes. So we figured just rough estimates, 3 students per section. So 22 sections, 11 on this side, 11 on this side. So 3 students and then maybe 1 to 2 adults for the detailed work with a finer brush. And 2 trucks. I'm sure we could get someone to volunteer a truck or 2 to have a water water jugs that we clean the brushes and a few other logistics that we can get into at a different time. If you go to the next slide, please. This is where we could add silhouettes of songbook musicians. Also, the sheet music could have actual songbook, kind of like the bronze statues actually read stuff when they have the paper. And it could actually read music or you know, clearly state certain musicians. We could add those silhouettes. We could also add different cityscape and kind of just whatever you all want. I think a good way to incentivize sponsors and to make it more appealing would be plaques outside of it and maybe press to discuss at a later time. But then there's sound and sensory elements that we could add. There's pretty good lighting, or those panels are pretty big, and we would have to discuss and different vendors for that, but projection. So if you've been to like certain malls with pianos on the ground, it would be really cool if somebody was riding their bike through and it picked them up and it played, you know, a tune of a jazz instrument or a songbook tune to their tempo of riding or anything like that. We could also, it could be seasonal. So you could even put fog machines in there and project onto those like a somebody playing, and then the speakers inside the same box. So a lot you could do there, you know, Halloween, but kind of like make that tunnel mysterious, and it all stays inside the tunnel, but you can hear it, you can see it, and make it an experience that brings a lot of attention to it outside of just Carmel. And so, yeah, that's really all I got today.
Okay, could I just jump in really quickly? This is Julia. We didn't do introductions at the start of the meeting because I was waiting for one or two other people to jump in. And so just if we could pause right here and just run through quick introductions, I really would appreciate it. I see that Karen is on, Christina is on, Kathy. I see a name, George Sang. George, can you tell us?
George is with Omni Productions, and he's Thank involved you. With doing a live stream on social media, so Facebook and so forth.
Thank you. Jeff Worrell, my counselor. Michael Klitzing, we've already referenced. Jen Bupp. We have Donna Tutwiler, Sharon Kibbe, Drew Doyle, Jill Reese, Kathy Strawn, and then a couple of others via phone. So those of you that if I didn't say your name and you're participating via phone, could you please let me know?
The 847 number is Kelvin Okamoto.
Thank you, Kelvin.
And Julia, Tim's on as well.
Oh, hi. Thank you, Tim. I appreciate that very much.
No worries.
So yeah, sorry. Is Bill Cooler still on? He had limited time. Okay. All right. We thank you very much. Why don't we go back to the presentation? I just thought we had critical mass at this point. So thank you very much.
Okay.
So if I could just say a couple of things too. So as John Michael and I were just brainstorming, you know, the ideas he just presented were exciting, because the idea of, you know, if we got more hands on board, if we could collaborate with different people as a community service outreach program, then yeah, we could create this tunnel as like an experience. You know, if it was something that involved the senses, then it would become a really cool thing for people using the Monon Trail to make it more than just, you know, a painted tunnel. So we were just pitching ideas, throwing out ideas to each other and trying to figure out, you know, how many hands can we get in this so it truly becomes a community service outreach. From our student standpoint, I love the idea of doing a vinyl wrap for the ceiling, again, to cut down on safety concerns. The ceiling to floor dimension in the tunnel is 7 feet. So we're already working with 7-foot tall walls, if you will. And with the paint by number application, basically that alleviates the need for having to worry about gridding and figuring out the exact dimensions once we have the design finalized. And that would make it so easy for, you know, anybody really from the community who wanted to come help, young kids, older kids. And then the idea being the detail work, then we would save for, you know, the artists who are accomplished and the adults and plenty of art teachers on board at Carmel High School. We can do the finishing details, but we did kind of like that concept of having a wrap for the ceiling that adheres to the surface and is secure, but then the walls would be the pieces that we paint.
All right.
Sounds really good.
Thanks, Jen.
Yes.
It sounds very exciting.
I think the whole project sounds exciting. I think the artwork has come a long way since our last meeting. And so I appreciate very much that you all took the input as kind of far-ranging as it was, took the input and discussion from the committee back to the students, and they've made the progress that they have. And I love the technology that's involved in it. And I also see great benefit to the number of students that you're going to be able to involve. I think that's fantastic too. And I think there'll be a lot of opportunity for growth and exposure to different types of techniques and technology. So I think it's wonderful, but I would love to open it up to committee members for their thoughts.
I'm Jill Reese, and I have a comment and a question. And my comment is, I'm blown away. I love it. I just love it, and it just hits a lot of points for me that I think, you know, the student involvement, Carmel student involvement, how the subject matter hits the arts. It's on our Monon Trail, which of course is a highlight for all of us. The experiential part of it. I don't know how easy it would be to, you know, get the music going, but I
love it. Is now exiting.
And the fact that, you know, the private sector, you're getting them involved, I really appreciate that as well. My question is, with John Michael, I feel like your name came up in our last meeting as an expert in this, but are you like a consultant to the high school? Are you donating your time? Are you
donating? Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you.
Absolutely. Yeah. I grew up in Carmel. My grandpa was one of the first custom home builders here, and I love it. That's why I've stayed. Oh. So really honored to be part of it. And that Jen and I were able to meet, and yeah, I love it.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Cause this is really, boy, it's really taken off, and, yeah, I'd love to show up and paint. So
yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
how are you good? Everyone's hand in this, for sure.
Yeah.
So Jen, I'm asking you, as far as the painting process, you would like to have community sponsors, correct? Like a day, I'm representing the Carmel Arts Council, as you know. Mm-hmm. So the Carmel Arts Council could come and paint a day. Is that how you're going to structure this?
We can, yeah. That's kind of the flexibility of this. Going the paint by number route is so less intimidating than, you know,
it is for some of us.
We had a mural that's, you know, 50 feet long. So that was kind of the idea. If we got some sponsors to join in, obviously we haven't finalize the budget yet. We still need the donations for the paints, the brushes, all that. But we thought, you know, what a beautiful cooperative liaison kind of going two ways we can create, you know, help donate to this project and then come be a part of it along with our students. And then everyone has a little hand in it. And then John Michael didn't discuss this yet, but we even had an idea. How cool would it be when the mural is either in process or finished, we could have Caroline do some beautiful works of art, like zoomed in features of the mural, like the cello or the music notes or music sheets, whatever. We could even have some sort of little auction, you know, and raise money for charities or whatever, taking images from the mural and then letting that become something too. So we were just excited. We just sat down with a blank sheet of paper and pencils and just, you know, how can we dream this? How could this become a really beautiful thing that really becomes an icon for the community?
It certainly is beautiful. It flows. It's music in the wind. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous.
And we're thrilled for Caroline because she's a very sweet, hardworking artist. And I know when we were talking about the design, if you guys have suggestions for things you'd like to add in, like we can still make manipulations or add in small details to the concept. We were thinking, should we add in a few little subtle silhouettes of the musicians? Should we make any of the instruments larger? Those decisions we can still make in the next couple of weeks, and we would love your input. But for Caroline, we want this to truly be her design. So that's why John Michael and I were saying, why not teach her how to vectorize? Sorry, that's my dog, Archie. Why not teach her how to vectorize your own images? Teach her the process. Hang on just a second.
And if you look at each one of the images within the image, they're all pieces of art. And so if we isolated those images and vectorized each one, they become their own asset. And so we could auction each piece as a lexicon, in the Tiny Museum or any of the museums as a collection, as part of the mural. And the mural can, that tunnel.
Well,
can
the Carmel Arts Council would love to have some of those images. So keep that in mind. We really would. Okay. We're closed right now because of COVID, but we hope and pray that by the summer we can start showcasing some things.
Thank you.
As we have for the last 20 plus years. So keep that in mind, please.
Councillor Hannon, I notice you have your hand raised here. Thank you for doing that to help
me. Oh, sure. No, I think it looks great. I really like that John Michael is also offering to let the students understand the digital side of it as well, so that they can be involved as much as humanly possible. And the design, the digitalization, the layout, all those things. So it really becomes a hands-on learning project for a lot of folks, which kind of just doubles the pleasure here. Mm-hmm. The other thing is it's always fun to kind of put Easter eggs in there somewhere, so to speak. Things you have to find. Mm-hmm. Actually, this is embarrassing. The FedEx logo, I never noticed it, but there's actually an arrow in the blank space.
Oh.
I just noticed that, which is embarrassing. But again, maybe encouraging the artist to also put in some Easter eggs and things like that might be fun too. I don't want to be the wet blanket here from a safety standpoint. I don't think probably fog in there is a great idea. A lot of people transiting there. And I guess people will have to get used to both being able to transit through there and enjoy it. Understanding it's a very, very busy byway. So kind of think of, if you had an art display on Rangeline Road. So again, not trying to throw a wet blanket on this at all. I think it's awesome, but also some consideration that people do have to transit there as mm-hmm. people are enjoying it.
Mm-hmm. Great point.
I think Drew? I agree with everybody. It's beautiful. It has really advanced, like you said, Julia. And I also agree with the fact that it is a very tricky space because we have a lot of bicyclists who love to speed through those mm-hmm. tunnels. And so I love the out-of-the-box thinking. And I think maybe music would be great, but the other sensory effects, let's do it someplace else.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If we can, let's not forget about it.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it's a tricky space. And I probably am one of those that, no, I don't go too fast, but I do go through there a lot. The only other thing I want to bring up, and I hope I don't make anybody upset, but I'm a musician and I'm a keyboard player, and I don't know how exact some of these things should, some of these elements should be. But I appreciate the fact that they're pretty true, with one exception that I noticed right away, and that is like the keyboard in the lower right, where it has two black keys and then some white keys and then another set of two black keys. And on a real piano, you'd have a set of two and then a set of three with a space of a white key in between. So. You just might have somebody check that out with the keyboard, because the rest of it is true and exact. And if it's a floating keyboard, then you
somebody might bring it up in addition to me.
Mm-hmm. Good point. Thank you.
Thank you. Michael, anything to add?
Well, first of all, I want to thank Jen and her students. Carolyn did a wonderful job, and John Michael for his generous donation of his services and the skills that he brings. Dr. Hannon, thanks for the fog. You beat me to it. I love the idea. It's very cool. But from a safety perspective, I would say that's probably something that we probably should avoid, at least for this application. And the other ones, I think, are things that we certainly can consider. And my probably question is, for example, if we don't have the funds right away for some of the, like the projection of the things or the sound, is that something that can be phased? Because I mean, I think it's very creative and, you know, something that I'm certainly interested in pursuing. And if we can't do it all at once, is it possible that we can add those additional components down the road?
Mm-hmm. That's probably more realistic, and that's what we had in there is a phase two on the mm-hmm. tech side of things. Get the mural going, execute it well, and then
perfect. Thank you. But great job. I'm super excited about it.
Can I just throw in a comment with regard to the question as to whether or not you add musicians to the artwork?
Mm-hmm.
And this is just a personal preference, but I would prefer not.
Okay.
Because I love the music, I love the instruments, I love the skyline, the tone. But as soon as a person is depicted, I'm no longer the musician in my mind. I like the fantasy of what this is, and it helps me see that I could be a musician as opposed to I'm watching a performer. Just my take on it. And I also believe once you start including people, it's a difficult field to navigate.
Okay.
If I could speak, Drew, I agree with your comment about making sure that the instruments are correct in how they're presented, because this is Sharon from the mayor's office. Trust me, if there's any instrument that's off, we will get a phone call about the fact that the instrument is incorrect or the music note is wrong. Yes. Trust me.
Yes. Somebody from the music department might look it over if you haven't already involved them.
That's a great idea. Yeah. Do we have any other comments about this, or are we ready to weigh in a little more formally using our intake form?
Hi,
Jill.
Hi. I know last week we spoke to some extent about the duration of the materials, the paints. Did we come to a conclusion as to that, or as far as whether we need to include that in
our
intake form?
Yeah, no, we spoke with regard to the duration of the placement because it was such a high profile placement, and understanding that this is a location, a placement location that could potentially be reimagined at another point in time rather than this being a permanent piece of art. So that was my recollection of anything relative to timing and the duration of placement.
So I think we left it that it would just appear in the minutes. You know, we just wanted the students to be aware that, you know, in 10 years when they come back from college or 15 years, I don't know, that if it's not there, we wanted that to be memorialized somewhere, I believe.
Right.
That.
Right. I think the time frame we talked about actually was 5 years.
Okay, right. Okay. Mm-hmm. I was being optimistic.
Thank you. I think it's beautiful, but I want to allow the next group to get the opportunity too.
All right. Well, it has been stated.
All right. Kelvin, are you able to walk us through the intake form, or are you not available to do that? But he's not available to do that. He normally handles that function for us. But I have it so I can do it if we'd like. And before I do, though, Dr. Hannon, your hand is still up in the Teams environment. Are you wanting to wait? Okay, thank you.
No, sorry about that.
That's okay. I didn't want to jump if you needed to make comment. The feedback on this piece, is the submission complete? I believe that it is. I think it's thorough. We understand that you will be moving forward with a little more thought with regard to the final execution, production and execution of the piece. But do the rest of you as committee members agree with that?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And then we really are just ready for vote on this piece. Are we prepared to accept this piece and its proposed application location, given the design, the production approach, or the technology used to approach it, and the teamwork involved, meaning 22 sections, 3 students per section, as well as looking at most likely a 5-year placement?
Is that a request for a motion?
I think it is, really, yeah.
Okay. Well, I would move that we vote to approve the submission as to location.
I'll second that.
Thank you. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed, same sign. All right. Thank you very much. This is really exciting because I think it's been a good process. And again, we appreciate very much how open the students were to all of our conversation and discussion. It's great to have the technology as well. And we just appreciate the opportunity that it is. We're just really excited. And by early July, we'll see it.
Julia, this is
Hi, Bill.
I heard you say that so this motion is approved for location, but is it not, is it approved for subject and everything else?
Yes. The word location was moved. I get good, thank you for that clarification. I think location and the art itself is approved, is what we're considering.
Would that include some consultation with musicians? Is that assumed?
Yeah, we will make sure that we consult and make sure that musical instruments are accurate.
Okay.
And then also, would you appreciate as a committee just the color palette choices, kind of seeing a board of the colors to approve and then open it up to perhaps any fine-tuning suggestions for the final design? I'm trying to figure out the next step, what format would be best.
I'll start. I am hesitant to go too much further in the design by committee approach.
Okay.
And if other committee members feel differently, please let's talk about that.
That's exactly how I felt.
Okay.
I agree.
Yeah.
Me as well.
Thank you. Thank you all very much. And I will also offer this. If you want to come back to the committee with any updates or other thoughts, we would love to see that along the way. We appreciate how collaborative you've been.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Michael, I'll circle back with both of you. I'll send you out an email. I want to make sure that we get John Michael talking to my Michael Allen, who's our Parks and Natural Resources Director. He can give an update on the actual repairs that we're making to address some of those concerns that you identified with the scaling and stuff. So I think it'd probably be good to get the two of you coordinated so you're working from the same page as well. But thank you.
Awesome. Fantastic. Thank you all for the time.
Thank you.
Very much.
Bye.
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 Okay, next item on the agenda is to just have a quick run through on communications and input update. I just wanted to make sure that everybody knows that we do now have a Facebook page, and that's actually how this meeting is being shared with the public at this point in time. Hopefully you've seen that page and connected or followed it and such. In addition, though, Jennifer did a really good job. She set up the general email. And we've received, and so thank you to her for that, and we've received a couple of emails. So I wanted to be sure, did everybody see them?
No.
Okay, no. Well, if you would just bear with me, I'll read them, because I think they're nice. We'll read the ones that aren't nice, too, when we get not nice.
Wait, could you give us the date, too, these came in? And
yes, absolutely. March 8th, which was Monday, a week ago Monday. Mary Bustani, Boustani.
Okay.
Right. I love the new art in the roundabout here. Can't wait for them to finish up the grounds around it. Not sure why people complain so much, but I like seeing the various roundabouts and what is on them. Keep up the good work exposing people to art, all caps on the word art. Okay. So Mary is in the, I can't tell what her physical address is, what part of town she lives in. The next one came in on March 8th.
Julia?
Yes.
Does everyone know what that, which roundabout that she's speaking of?
No, I'm only reading to you what I have, Bill.
Oh, because the title of the subject, I think there's a title of it indicating which roundabout it is.
106 and Ditch. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you. Sorry. The second one came in on March 8th. Its subject just is public art. I'd like to say how much I enjoy and appreciate the public art in Carmel, including the time and effort spent on original designs for our many traffic roundabouts. I'm very disappointed by some of the narrow views expressed on platforms such as Nextdoor, and I disagree with the idea of putting decisions like these to some kind of popular vote. I don't love every piece selected, nor what I expect to, but I value the diversity and believe they truly enrich our community.
So, and who was that from? I'm sorry.
David Garner.
Okay.
G-A-R-N-E-R.
Okay.
And again, I'm not certain what side of town he lives on, whose district he's in. So just a quick update there I wanted to share with all of you.
Okay. May we offer some feedback to the city and to the rest of the committee?
Okay.
So the email address that we discussed last week, I was under the impression that when Jennifer or whoever is monitoring that email address would be forwarding those to us. Is that no longer the expectation or the plan?
She was to forward them to Karen and I as co-chairs, and then we are to share them with you all. Since these were the first two we'd ever received, wanted to give it a little more thrill.
Okay.
At any rate,
okay.
Co-chairs will receive and then distribute to committee members.
Like as necessary, like will you be gatekeepers? Or...
I understand. I think I understand the spirit and intent of your question. If you would like, we can just send them as we receive them. One thing I am concerned about, though, is that we really use the committee meetings to focus the committee work, as opposed to outside of the committee via email and other forms of interaction, because it doesn't allow the whole group to participate. So it would be more my thought to package them and send them in advance of the committee, if that's okay. If people see value to providing them prior to that, I'm certainly open to that.
Yeah, I think it may be a learning experience as we go along and see what we receive. It does tie in to some degree with the public art discussion points that we came up with, which we can get into a little later, just depending on the subject matter of the email. So let's just, I just wanted to be aware of what to expect as I communicate with people in the public. Like, here's your email address, here's what you can expect in response, so our citizens are also, they know if they send this off, who's going to see it and what have you.
Right. I think that's a very reasonable line of discussion. Does anybody on the committee have any guidance for us or feel differently? I would say this, Karen and I, if we feel that something just rises to a level of concern that should be advanced to you sooner, we can certainly do that.
Okay.
Okay.
I also have, I don't know if this is the proper time to raise this, but as we look at our landing page and we see that, you know, the notice for the meeting goes out and the agenda, and then there's a link at the bottom to Laserfish, which would have, in theory, all of our minutes. The minutes are not there that I can find. So I think I've brought this up a couple times. And the intake forms are, the historical intake forms are all there. So that's great. But my question is about process. When we have a meeting that's coming up and an intake that's coming up, will that be, you know, will the public be able to see it prior to the meeting? Is there any expectation or not necessarily? Again, my point is to be able to, you know, if we are endowed with the responsibility for sort of representing the citizens, you know, what can they expect?
It would seem reasonable and consistent to me that when the agenda is posted, the meeting materials that support that agenda could also be posted. However, I will defer to, because I think that's consistent with other boards, commissions, committees that represent Carmel and serve the citizens of Carmel. I will defer, though, to either Sharon or Dr. Hannon or Councillor Worrell.
Jennifer certainly is a good source as well for those sort of procedural questions. And I actually just found the Facebook site. I'm sorry I didn't know it was there. Hopefully you'll let me join. But I think the public input form is a great idea. You'll get a small smattering of what Councilor Worrell and I get on a daily basis. You get the occasional thank you. You get a lot of creative tips. Let me just say that.
Yeah. Hey, Julia, this is Jeff. Would you mind repeating the question for me? We lost Julia.
Uh-oh.
Maybe Jill can repeat it.
Well, Julia was asking you to weigh in on the procedures for posting items that would support the agendas that are posted on our CPAAC landing page. Mm-hmm. So we can see the agenda, but we cannot necessarily see the proposed minutes or the proposed intakes prior to the meeting. And she felt, there she is again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes.
Councilor Worrell was just asking you to restate the question.
Oh, my statement was that it seemed reasonable and consistent that the agenda and any supporting meeting materials would be posted at the same point in time in the same location, similar to any matter for other boards, committees, or commissions that support the city of Carmel and serve the citizens of Carmel.
Yeah, yeah. And those don't necessarily go on the landing pages. There, as you guys have probably seen, there's a separate place where the agenda that matches with the video. So I think it's just a matter of asking Jennifer to, you know, see that through. But I would fully support that. Absolutely. We want as many materials to be publicly available as possible.
Okay. I will then be happy as a co-chair. I'll be happy to connect with Jennifer to make sure that we understand that procedure. She is fully aware that we're looking at her to help execute that, not help, but to execute that procedure going forward. Is that all right with everyone?
Yes.
Thank
yes.
you very much, Jill.
Thanks. That's appropriate.
Yeah. Yes. Thank you. And if she says what, I'll say talk to Sharon.
Yes. All right. Yeah. That is absolutely appropriate, Julia. Yes.
Thank you.
Hi, Julia. When we get those Facebook comments, is there a protocol for responding to them, or does the writer know that?
Oh, Facebook.
The two that you read.
Those are not Facebook. Those are emails. And Jennifer has just a standard reply to thank them for their input. We haven't had anything yet that requires much more than that. But again, I would think that Karen and I, as co-chairs, and given the weight of the input, we might bring it to committee before we respond. But we could respond to that, unless you all feel that every one of them needs to come to committee to confirm reply.
I think you all being screening them is fine.
I do too.
I agree. Okay,
that sounds good.
Or I'll take a volunteer if somebody else wants to. Screening and responding, great. But Karen and I can screen and respond and determine what we need to bring on. Do we want to move forward now to the art evaluation points and the revised intake form, or actually the art discussion points? Jill, Karen, Drew, the three of you.
I'm going to exit. Have a great evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. I enjoyed it.
Thank you, Sharon, very much.
Bye.
Bye.
Jill, Karen.
Sure.
Drew. Work together over the course of 8 weeks to draft, take some input, and bring to us what I think is a really good framework as to guide us through discussions relative to the art, given our expanded role with the revised ordinance. So, Jill, do you want to start, or who's going to start this?
Jill. I was going to defer to Drew, but.
Are you serious?
Yeah. I talk a lot.
Can somebody put it on the screen? I don't actually have it.
Okay. Well, if you don't have it right there, I'd be happy to speak to it. Our subcommittee, Drew, Karen, and I met via Zoom last week to revise post our last full committee meeting. Per the comments you made, we possibly went a little further than the comments because we saw in new areas that could use some revision. So we reorganized and we deleted the public input portion, and we narrowed that down and fit some concern for public input into the other at the bottom. Mm-hmm. But, I think the document somewhat speaks for itself. Again, our intent was to provide bullet points that we can go through each time we get an intake as a springboard for discussion. We were really trying hard not to make value judgments that were already baked in. That is very challenging.
I think that's very true, though.
Apologies, guys. I'm sorry.
That's okay. There you go. Right. So if there are any bullet points that are not clear, though, you can bring that up now or later. But just with us three, each one of us would say, what do you mean with that? And then it was a good indicator that it wouldn't be understood by anyone. Or we can just use it next time we have an intake and it will be revealed what is unclear.
Correct.
Okay.
When I saw the piece late last week, I thought the task force, the group, had made really good progress to bring it forward to something that we can use just as a discussion framework. It's not a rubric that you would use to evaluate art. It is a consistent framework that each of us can use as a starting point for our discussion relative to a piece of art that is submitted. I anticipate that it will be a living, breathing item that will evolve a little bit. And that's okay. That is okay. I think it's a great piece to start with. It may grow or change.
Mm-hmm. Any questions about it?
No, Jill, I think it's very extensive, very thorough, and covers all bases. And certainly there'll be certain points that will be more important based upon what it is that we're evaluating.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I think a logical next step then would be to either incorporate or add this to our intake form so those that are submitting understand and are aware, just in this, you know, spirit of proactive communication, understand what we will be mm-hmm. reviewing the art, what the basis is for the art review.
I agree. We had discussed as a subcommittee, you know, I had raised that putting it into the intake form, and we weren't sure how exactly that would be, but it's just almost like an addendum, you know, yeah. or this is mm-hmm. what, you know, this is what will be used, yeah. like you say, almost like a rubric, but not that
not concrete. A scored rubric.
Right, yeah. right.
I think it's almost fair to have it on there because I think if somebody is submitting an intake form, they may want to know what our thoughts are for discussing their work, if I'm understanding everything right, correct?
Correct.
Yeah, I agree.
It and helps them.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yes. All right.
Right. So again, and the reason for this was because our mission expanded to give a non-binding opinion to the mayor and his advisors about the actual acquisition of art. And how do you do that past, do you personally like it? And that was the reason for these discussion points.
It's really well done.
I think
impressive.
It is.
Yeah. Very impressive.
Well,
so if the mayor then is recommending a particular sculptor or artist to produce a piece of art or something in a roundabout or wherever it may be, then who is it that's filling out that form? The mayor, his staff, the artist, the staff, their staff. Okay. Gotcha.
The staff has filled out and paperwork for previous submissions as well on behalf of the artist. Sometimes the artist does, but the staff has as well.
Okay.
And I know the mayor in the town hall that Jeff hosted recently expressed, you know, his intention to have a new online process by which the city could receive submissions, and maybe this will play a part in that, you know, maybe not. We'll see. But that was exciting news.
Yes. I'm hopeful that that particular item can be included in a report from the city at an upcoming meeting.
Yes, I agree.
Yeah, I can tell you it's a 2022 initiative.
Oh, okay. So maybe not the next meeting. Okay.
Well, yeah, they're going to build a website and a whole thing for it. So.
Great. Thank you. All right. Another part of this discussion point was to be what constitutes public art. That was something that you wanted to.
That was something that I initiated, and it was interesting. In one of the emails we got on our city email, I did look at the link that was sent to us that is on the city's website. And I don't recall exactly what it was entitled, but it was basically a link to public art locations, and then you saw the map and were able to mm-hmm. click on each of the, I'm going to say 38 or 41 different points in the city and around the city. And some of them had just a name or just an image. And then some of them had, you know, a nice description of what the piece was and who did it and all of that. It wasn't real consistent, but I think that goes hand in hand with, you know, what we're doing, because when you look at those pieces, one of them is there in the village of West Clay near me, which is a roundabout with you know, parterre, or basically hedges, in, you know, an ornate pattern of hedges with a fountain and a fountain structure in the middle. And that was called, you know, that's public art. And then others were murals on the sides of buildings. And then obviously lots of them were sculptures, mm-hmm. some of the human character, human elements, human pieces, humans, dogs, and, you know, different animals, whatever we had around the city. Mm-hmm. And then there's lots of abstract art and whatnot. But and then when, you know, a month or so ago, when I had passed by the 106th and Ditch Road and took a photograph of some beautiful limestone large tablets that were cut in an ornate manner, and then applied to those were metal etchings that are applied to the face, and then there's a large bowl in the center. And I believe it may be a fountain, but it may be a planter. I think I'd heard a fountain. And that's when I brought up, well, you know, who approved that? And since it is a recent one, and I think the city had gone so far as to indicate that maybe that got by and was not reviewed by our committee over the last year. but there's lots of variety of mm-hmm. public art. I'm on other committees, and one of them is a beautification committee for the campus, the Jewish Community Center campus. And, you know, and that gets down to maintenance items and all kinds of other, any improvements and things like that. So, but I'm not thinking that we go so far as need to, you know, review and approve, you know, building architecture that the city approves. But I just thought we need to talk about it a little bit more. You know, we did talk a month or two ago with the Morning Sun, and that, you know, I'm hoping that there'll be landscaping or grasses or something done in the roundabout around the base of it. But yet we didn't see or approve any of that, so we don't know. But, you know, is it, you know, when there's every time they go to landscape a roundabout, do we have a part in it? Do we review it? If there's just trees and landscaping in the middle, is that one thing? As soon as they put a piece of carved stone, limestone, metal structure, accent lighting, a fountain, at what point does our committee review something?
Thank you, Bill. What we have been advised of in the past is that landscape art, meaning if a living shrub or hedge or whatever is takes on a particular form, that it would not be submitted to this committee as public art. It is landscaping, and any supporting materials like limestone or metal as a part of a landscape design would not be submitted to this committee.
Let me ask then.
Well, I'm just saying.
If you look at 116th Street and the two roundabouts there at Guilford and College, mm-hmm. that has more of a traditional looking brick, curved brick walls and limestone caps. And mm-hmm. I still am not sure exactly what's going on with that, but pretty substantial.
Right. So I appreciate your question, Bill. This is Jill. And going back a few months when we were looking at the new proposed ordinance, revised ordinance, and then I took on just wordsmithing it, when it came to the definition of public art, it was this big question mark. It is one of those sort of existential questions. What is art? you know, what is music? A lot of things qualify that we might not agree on, but I, you know, I did a lot of online research to come up with that. And we, our ordinance, you know, the definition is any work of art in any media, which doesn't really help us answer your question. It is, it was, on my part at least, intentionally broad, but I guess the question is, you know, how do we further define without having to change the ordinance all the time? You know, can we as a committee have, you know, almost like resolutions or documents that survive as, you know, we have rollover, like sort of institutional memory that, like, kind of like what you're saying, like, you know, landscape or, you know, topiary is landscape. It is not art for purposes of this committee. You know what I mean? How do we do that so we remember and we have guidelines that...
Well, a suggestion would be that we appreciate the work that the task force did. Maybe they would double down and offer some definitions. Hey, Drew, I saw that.
Hey, just a full-time job. It's no problem.
You never get out. Is that what you're saying?
Just joking.
To maybe just draft some thoughts with regard to, because it's to media process, you know, is a landscaper an artist kind of thing, you know, working through a little bit of that to begin to form that construct and institutional memory. I think we have to start with something.
Let me recommend one. I started writing a sentence and I just kept changing a little bit. Something like any non-living vertical element meant to be a focal point. Anything that's meant to be a focal point. Now, in non-building, so a focal point is and non-living, and it's something vertical, not just a plaza or something like that. But I mean, it could be a painting on the wall.
The mural.
The mural.
Yeah.
It's meant to be a focal point.
Yes.
And it's vertical.
Yeah.
I guess my question is it binding? When does it become binding on the city? You know, procedurally.
Right.
You know,
that's a very good question. And that's where I think the two counselors can help us at this point, and just in terms of guidance on that. Dr. Han, something you want to say?
Yeah, I think I would continue to wordsmith this and look at what other organizations have done. I didn't want to get into the whole, you know, pornography when you see it sort of a thing, you know, art when you see it. But I think, rather than, you know, my opinion or Bill's opinion or, you know, Julia's opinion, what have other reputable, established public art commissions done? How have they defined it? Which, you know, may be better than just sort of guessing what it would be.
Right.
And I would also, you know, say, and it's not a stay in your lane sort of a thing, but there may be things that hopefully we can clearly define and all agree on that you should be involved in. But that doesn't mean that you could be an adjunct to the folks that are doing the landscaping or doing some of the engineering and things like that as well, too. So I think one thing is to define what specifically by ordinance that you are entitled, supposed to be, you know, whatever the proper term is, to be involved in. And again, I'd look at precedents for that. But again, not to, you know, like I said, sort of get in line that we do have, you know, engineering, we do have landscaping people, for example, for the streets department. There are streets department people that have actually gone to courses on public landscaping and things like that. I think they actually went to a Disney class, unless that got canceled by COVID. And I'm saying we do have that expertise. But it doesn't mean that there can't be a role potentially for this committee, even if not formal, informally, to be involved in that. I think you've got a lot of really super smart people on this, with a lot of good perspectives. It would be useful, perhaps, maybe at a future meeting, because you're sort of talking about landscaping and hardscaping and all those other things that I actually really like. I have no talent as an artist, but I like hardscaping and landscaping. You know, maybe having Jeremy or the streets department talk about what they do and how they do it. I mean, even just from a educational standpoint, I'd probably enjoy that as well.
I agree. I see Donna's hand is up.
Yeah, I'm. As we're talking about the art and the roundabouts, you might want to think about a painting, and you put a frame around it. And the frame is important to the painting. The painting is important to the frame. You just wouldn't just put any frame around a picture. So to me, the landscaping around, the lighting, all of that goes with the art itself. Just as a frame would go with a painting. That's just my thought.
Thank you. Karen, is that your hand up?
It is, and I was going to make a comment after you suggested that Drew, Jill, and I sort of tackle this as we did the art evaluation points. And I was going to suggest it's really good to put a small committee together. It saves time in our regular meetings if a committee can come in with some discussion points. And I was going to suggest maybe Bill Cooler would put together, either do it himself or put together a small group to look into this, since he initially brought it to our attention.
Thank you. Bill, are you willing and interested?
Sure, I will take that on.
Okay, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Yeah, thank you. All right, good discussion. Anything else we need to cover on that at this point?
No, I mean, it harkens back to a discussion we had a few months ago, but about where the art appears, but I am not going to go there. I think that we should wait until that comes up again to see, you know, where we land. Yeah.
Yep. Okay, very good. That means we're ready to adjourn the meeting unless anyone has anything else to add for the good of the discussion.
My only other question was on our discussion points and getting that into the intake form. Whose job is that? Do we have a keeper of the form?
Kelvin has been the keeper of the form. Kelvin, are you still on?
I don't think so.
Okay. I will connect with Kelvin and we will get that form revised.
Okay.
Is that right? Or do one of you committee members that took on this want to do it?
Oh, no. That's fine. As long as you have the most updated version, you know, the...
Yeah. All right.
I don't have anything else. I will
connect on that. Okay. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. All right. I think we're ready for adjournment then. Can I get a motion to adjourn?
I'll move to adjourn.
All right, I'll second that. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Good
aye.
Aye.
Thank
you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. See ya. Good job.